Greetings, and welcome back to Education and More's Learn Python 3 Programming at a Snail's Pace. My name is Marcus Gardner, and I'm the instructor for this class. This is our third video on putting it all together. We'll see if we can finish this in this video, otherwise the fourth video will be the last one. In this video, we are still trying to get Barney Fife to catch up with Otis the town drunk. Okay? Now, we are ready. We have finished coding the get direction. One thing we didn't do is put comments. Okay? Now, for get direction is actually easy as well. This one, the input is none. And for the output, we are going to say what the direction is. Output one of four directions. Okay? Depending on where Otis is in relation to Barney. Okay? So if Otis is north of us, we need to go north or up. Okay? As we did up. Okay? That's it. That's all we need. Oh, plus we also found a distance. Okay? But for the output, that's all we're doing. Okay? Get the four directions. But also, are we either going up, down, or are we going left, right? Okay? Let's see. Output one of the directions. This is dependent, depending on two things. One, where Otis is, and how far in that direction. Okay? So, one of four directions. Let's go ahead and delete the rest of this. There we go. Okay. And that's it. Let's see how far is that direction. So we can minimize area of right triangle. Okay. One thing you might want to think about is explaining that the shortest distance will be the way to go to minimize area of the triangle. Okay? So that is something you might want to put in here in the future. All right. So let's continue. Now we have the direction. Now we can just move. That is the easy part. So let's call make a move. Now the output, of course, is going to be our new coordinates. And, you know, let's see. Make a move. Okay. Now this is going to actually cause us some problems, but we'll talk about that in a minute. We can easily change these variable names. Okay. All right. So make a move. So again, we're going to define make a move. So we're going to put that here. Define make a move. So we know, we had to tell it what direction. So we're going to pass it the direction as well as the X and Y coordinates of Otis and Barney. Okay. Now the direction doesn't tell us where to make Otis move, but that's okay. We need it for Barney's move. Otis's move is random. Okay. All right. So, let's see here. Direction. So, if direction is equal to up, then Y Barney is equal to Y Barney plus 1. Okay? Now we just have three others. So here I'm going to do the elif. I need to do elif. I don't want to do if again. Okay? I could do if, but elif is better. Okay. Elif direction is equal to down. Then we want y Barney is equal to y Barney minus 1. Elif direction is equal to right. Then we want x Barney is equal to x Barney plus 1. Else, well, there's only four cases. We don't need an elif. We want x Barney equal to x Barney minus 1 because it went left. That's the only direction left. Because remember, Barney is only allowed to go four directions. Okay, it's Otis who can do the 8 directions plus stay there, so that's 9 total. Okay, now we can do the movements for Otis in this function, but I'm going to create another function. Okay, and so I am going to get as a return make Otis move. So I'm going to take Otis's XY define make Otis move. Okay. Because when we make Otis move, we only need to know his original position. Okay? All right. So, what do we do? We're going to make a random number. Okay? All right. So, let's just say num is equal to random dot randint 1 to 9. Okay? If num is equal to 1, again, you can assign these however you want. You can be haphazard. You can say 1 is north, 2 is southeast, 3 is southwest, you know, however you want to do it, okay? I'm just going to go in a clockwise order, okay? Put some rhyme or reason to it. It makes it a little bit easier for debugging, okay? All right. If num is equal to 1, I am going to say print Otis, whoops, need quotes. Otis is moving north. Okay? All right, let's see here. Anything else we need to do there? Nope. And then we're going to return X Otis, comma Y Otis plus 1. Okay? And now elif num equals 2. Okay? Print Otis is moving northeast. All right, not exactly sure about the spelling. Is it? I assume that's correct. Anyway, I'm not going to worry about it. You can do that if you want. All right, and then I'm going to return X Otis plus 1, Y Otis plus 1. Okay, because that's what northeast is, going north and going east. Okay, elif num is equal to 3, print, whoops, I said print twice, aye. There we go, Otis is moving east. Okay. Return X Otis plus 1 and then Y Otis, the original. Okay. Elif num is equal to 4. Print Otis is moving southeast. Return X Otis plus 1, Y Otis minus 1. Now I am making an assumption here. I am assuming you remember your coordinate geometry, okay? And that is where right is the X values going up, left X values going down, up Y values going up, and down Y values going down, okay? So I did make that assumption. So hopefully you haven't forgot about those. If you did, you might want to take a quick look at a graph. All right. Otis is moving southwest. Let's see. South. There we go. North, northeast, east, southeast, south. Yes, there we go. Return X Otis and Y Otis minus 1. Elif num equals 6. Later on we'll find another easier way to do this, but for right now this is all we know. Print Otis is moving southwest, and I forgot a parenthesis here. Return X Otis minus 1, Y Otis minus 1. Elif num equals 7. Print Otis is moving west. Return X Otis minus 1, Y Otis. Elif num equals 8. Print Otis is moving northwest. Return X Otis minus 1, Y Otis plus 1. And else, because it's number 9, print Otis didn't move. Return X Otis, Y Otis. All right. Now, this is one way to do it. Okay? Another way to do it, and probably a little better. Okay? Because one of the things we didn't do is to, you know, write it out on paper. You know, I don't like spending a lot of time doing that unless I'm confused about something. For example, the area of the triangle, that was necessary to write on paper. But here, it doesn't make it hard to, you know, erase, you know, it was with the computer, okay? But another thing we could have done is gotten rid of all of these return statements and put in something like Y Otis equals Y Otis plus 1. And for this one, X Otis equals X Otis plus 1, Y Otis equals Y Otis plus 1, all the way down here. And then at the very end, do return X Otis, Y Otis. Okay. I think this is faster. May or may not be as clean as the other way. So it really depends upon your thinking. No one's going to get upset at you if you do it this way or the other way. Okay? Because there's really not a lot of extra work done. Okay? This one has a lot of return statements, but again, it only hitting the return statement once. Okay? It's not like it's hitting it many times. You see lots of return statements, but only hitting it once. So this would be faster, but it may not be as clean as the other one. But anyway, that's really a judgment call. So, you know, maybe your boss will say, hey, it's better if you do it the other way. You know, put in the values here. Y Otis equals Y Otis plus one, not touching X Otis. Okay, same thing here, like down here. X Otis equals X Otis minus one, not touching the Y Otis. And then down here, the very last thing, after you finished all these if else's, then return X Otis, Y Otis. And then you won't even need this. Okay, so that is one small benefit. You won't need this other else statement because it's not changing X Otis, Y Otis. However, you will actually do need it because you need to say Otis didn't move. Okay, never mind. Okay, so I just wanted to give you that little thought there. So there's another way to do this that you know how to do, and that is making the return statement at the end here. Okay? All right. So that should be it for the X Otis, Y Otis. Good. So make a move. Now we can return. We want the Otis first, then Barney. As I said, variable names are usually not important, but in this case, they are going to be important. I'll explain why in a second. So we want Otis is first. So I'm going to return X Otis, Y Otis. And then X Barney, Y Barney. Okay. All right. So make a move. All right. Let's see here. We've only got one more function to do, so I'm not going to test it right now. Okay. Normally I would, but I'm going to see if I can get this video done for this big project here. All right. This actually is the last thing we need to do except for one small piece. Do you remember at the beginning when I said there was three ways to catch? And that was when they pass each other. Okay. So right now, we need to know if they passed. Well, in order to know that, you need to know the previous positions of Otis and Barney. This is going to wipe it out. Okay? See, we have the originals here. We're passing it in here. And we're overwriting it here. So, I'm going to change this to new. New. This way, I am going to have both the old positions and the new positions of Otis and Barney. So right now, the way I coded it when I first coded it last year was I created another function to see did they switch, which is fine. You could do that, but it's really just one if statement. So I'm not going to make a new function. I'm just going to do an if statement here. Okay? So what I'm going to say is if... Oh, I got a double underscore here. If X new Otis is equal to X Barney and Y new Otis is equal to Y Barney, and now That's the new position of Otis occupying the old position of Barney. That's not good enough. Okay? Because Barney could have went in the, another direction. We need to see if Barney's position, new position, is equal to Otis's old position. Okay? And X new Barney is equal to X Otis. And Y new Barney is equal to Y Otis. Okay? Then print, they met in passing. Okay? And so what I'm going to do here, now I know why I use the other thing. But anyway, what we can do is use the direction. We know what the direction is. Okay. But anyway, I'm still going to keep it here. And then you can decide if you want to move it into another function or not. Okay. Because remember, I wanted to say that they met at the halfway point. Okay. So if direction is equal to up, then I am going to return X. It doesn't matter which one because they're both now, well, they have switched, okay? So I'm going to look at Barney's, okay? It doesn't matter which one. I could always change the values of either one. I'm just going to look at Barney's, okay? I'll explain in just a minute. Barney moved up. Otis moved down. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make Barney only move up half instead of a whole one. Okay? Otherwise, I could have looked at Otis. Otis went down, and so I could have made him only go down a half. So either way is fine. So return X new Barney, or it doesn't matter, X Barney or X new Barney. It doesn't matter as long as you change the values correctly. I'm going to choose X Barney. Return X Barney plus 0.5. Okay. Oh, we're not returning anything. I tried. I didn't create a function. All right. So I am going to say print Barney let's just see. No, I want to do the print later. So I'm just going to change this X. Let's see here. Oh, okay. I got this X Otis. All right. We're going to have a small problem here. Okay. Ah, I know a way to fix that. All right. Let me explain what's going on here. Okay. So I am going to just change X Otis X. Yeah, we're going to change all those values. All right, let me think for a second. The reason why I'm thinking is because here I said we are going to go until these are both equal. But notice I have changed the new values. Okay? All right. So, what I want to do is get rid of this break. Okay? And I am wanting to change the X new Otis's over to X Otis. So that's going to be our new positions. Okay? So let's do that. X Otis is equal to X new Otis. Okay? Y Otis is now equal to Y old Otis. X Barney is equal to X new Barney. And Y Barney is equal to Y new Barney. All right. So, I am going to do compare here. Okay? So, if the direction is up, then I want to say that the X new Barney, I'm only going to worry about the new stuff here. Okay? The new Barney went too far up. So X new Barney is equal to X new Barney minus 0.5. Okay? I am not going to change the Y new value. Sorry. Up. This should be Y. And this will be Y. I am not going to change the X new Barneys. That's going to stay the same. Okay? Elif, direction is equal to down. We're going to say that the Y new Barneys, I'm going to have to add back a half, because if it went down, it went minus one. Well, we only wanted to go down a half. Okay? All right. Now, we're going to have to come back and change the Otises as well. But anyway. So anyway, let's go ahead and finish this up. Elif, direction is equal to right. That means I went over one. So that means the X new Barney went too far. So I need to say X new Barney minus 0.5. Else, again, I don't need elif. I'm going to put plus 5. Okay. Now the thing is, we're copying over the new Otises, so I need to actually update the Otis ones also. Y new Otis is equal to Y new Otis plus 0.5. Because remember, if Barney is going down, Otis is going up. That's the only way it's going to switch values. So each one of these, we're going to have to be complete opposite of the one previous. So this one's got to be a minus 0.5. So here, X new Otis is equal to X new Otis plus 0.5. Let me copy that. Minus. Okay, that should be it. So let's see if this is correct. Okay, so this is going to make this at the end of each move. We're going to go back, so that should be okay. And then at the very end, we're going to say print Barney has Otis in custody at, it doesn't matter which one, because they're now equal. Okay, so X Barney, comma, Y Barney, comma, and that's it. There we go. All right, let's give it a shot. All right, let's see if there are any errors. There might be. Okay. So let's see here. I think I still have it up. There we go. Let's try again. output, one of the directions, line 25. Ah. Comment, I was wondering why it was so far up there. Okay, let's try again. Ah, forgot my colon. Line 114. All those others correct? Yes. Try again. Is third time a charm? Yay. All right, zero, zero. Why not define page one, I mean, not line 119. Okay. Ah, I put old instead of new. All right. There we go. No more olds, right? No, 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 no. Good. Zero, zero. All right. 19.55. Okay. Now, have we finished? Okay. Nope. Now, for one thing, this is going to get hard to check. So we should say what the position is after each move. And also, we had one more requirement. Let's show what that requirement is. We are to say how many moves it took. Okay, so let's go ahead and fix those two items. Well, actually, I want you to fix them. So I would like for you to pause the video. And what I want you to do is print the position of both after every move. So that way you can visually see that this is correct. Remember at this first position here, we said direction is down, and we could see that down is the correct move. Okay? So we want to see the updates. Where did they move? What's the new position? And see that everything is correct, okay? And then I want you to put in a counter. Where would the counter go? So pause the video, try to do the update yourself, okay? Okay, hopefully that's enough time for you to pause the video. All right, so what I'm gonna do right here, I hate it typing in all of those quotation marks and stuff. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy that sentence and just change something here. All right. Let's see. Make a move. There we go. Right here. And Barney is now is at. And Otis is at. Okay. Except now we're going to have to put in the new. So, all right, but this is going to cause a small problem. All right. Because it's not technically correct, is it? Why is this not technically correct? Not technically correct because we changed the position here. Okay, so let's do this. Let's cut that out and do it here. Well, so that means I didn't really need the new. I could have put it down here and just use X Otis. I mean X Barney. Oh well. I didn't think that through very well. Like I said, we make mistakes. All right. So in other words, what I was talking about is, remember I added all those news in there? I didn't have to. I could just put the print statement here. Okay? So right there and just don't have the news in there. Okay? All right. Anyway, it's okay. But now counter. All right. I like using CT for counter, okay? So CT equals zero, and then let's see here. I am going to add one before they make a move. Well, you can do it right after they make a move. It's fine. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Right before, right after, it doesn't matter. CT equals CT plus one. Okay, but can CT ever equal to zero? Yes. Remember, we are in a 20, from a negative 2020 to a positive 2020. Okay, that's a 1600 grid. All right. So there is this remote possibility, one in 1600s, where the position you start is the position that Otis starts. Okay? So yes, it is possible. Remember, right here, right after we get the starting positions, and we say, as long as they're not equal. Well, what if they're equal? Well, we had the custody right away. So no moves was made, so it's possible that they got it in zero moves. Okay? So right here, we're going to add a small little part in CT moves. There we go. Now, how could you test to make sure that the CT equals zero actually worked for the very beginning? Obviously it does. But let's assume that there is a certain program that you are working on where it's possible that the CT equals zero doesn't work, or I can't imagine right now, but I remember in the past I had to test for it. Well, what you can do is right up here, when you are getting the random position, you can print his random position and then you type in the exact same numbers. Okay? So that's the way to test the initial condition. It's what we call an endpoint. Okay? The endpoints is what gets many programmers into trouble. They forget about the endpoints. Later on, we learn about strings. You know, we'll do something up to the end of the, at the end of the string, but some programmers forget to test the end of the string or the very beginning of the string. Okay? Especially if you're looking at the previous letter. Well, at the beginning of the string, there is no previous letter. Okay? So don't worry about that. We'll talk about strings more in depth later. But just remember, not only do you need to make test cases for the middle, but you also need to make test cases for the ends. Okay? All right. So this should take care of it. Hopefully there's no other errors. And let's go ahead and test it. 0, 0. Took 50 moves. All right, let's just test one here. 15, negative 10. Direction is left. Well, in this case, it could have been either. But because it could have been either, that is fine. Okay? So let's go up a little bit higher here. Otis didn't move. Oh, that's even great. Okay, see, didn't move. Okay, direction is down. And this time, direction is right. Okay? Because this one was one away. And this one's 11 away, so of course, go towards that one. But now it's zero, so now you have to go based upon the X. So yeah, this looks great. Okay. Let's see, anything else? Moving southwest, let's just test it. Okay, Otis, moving southwest. So, the X is going, southeast rather, is going east, and the Y is going south, so yes, he did move southeast, so this looks good. Okay? All right. And so, did it 50 moves. Let's try again. 33 moves. Try again. 26 moves. Try again. 39 moves. Try again. 54 moves. Try again. 23 moves. That was even quicker. 39 moves. 26 moves. 125 moves. Okay. All right. Now, notice here, we may have a problem. This went out of bounds. Okay. This is another important thing about testing. You see, when we did our initial setup, we made it between negative 20 and 20. But when we made Otis go any direction we wanted, we did not restrain him to the negative 20, 20, and 20, 20 restriction. Okay? Now let's go back and see the instructions. It says here that he starts in a random position of here. It does not mention that he has to stay in this area. And remember, he's drunk. Okay? How are you going to tell a drunk you have to stay in this area? All right. So, that is something that you have to use your thinking. Do you do exactly what you are told, or do you raise this up to your supervisor and say, I was told the initial was between negative 20 to 20, but can somewhere in the middle be above, outside of those ranges? Okay, because as it's written here, what we've done is okay. But what if they say, no, it's not okay? Okay, then if you just said, I'm going to code it just as is, as many programmers do, then you're going to have problems. Okay, and testing is going to come back and say, hey, this one's a negative 30. And then you come back and say, well, this is what it says. They're not going to like you. Okay, you just can't be doing exactly what you're told. You are not a robot. You need to do your own thinking, okay? And say, you have to imagine that maybe your boss made a mistake or the customer made a mistake. You have to ask questions. Say, are you sure the customer meant this? Because according to this, it can go outside the square. Is that okay? That is a very important job of a programmer. So don't be like one of these automatons. Am I saying that correctly? Robots that will only do what it's programmed to do. Okay? Make the assumption that perhaps, the customer made a mistake and ask. The customer can always say, oh yes, it's okay. But you are letting the customer know that at least you're thinking. The customer will like you for that, okay? Now, some of them will be hard. Well, of course it's okay. You know, I didn't say it was restricted. What do you think? Why are you asking me? But most customers won't be that way. Okay? But anyway, at least let your boss know that you're thinking. He can decide whether to contact a customer or not. All right. So according to this, that's fine. So that makes an interesting homework problem. Yay! Recode it. Where cannot go outside. Let's assume there's a big old electrified fence. Woohoo! And Otis cannot go outside negative 20 to 20. Okay? What changes would you make? Okay. All right. So we are done here. And I hope you've enjoyed this series. And I hope you learned a lot. Okay? Thank you very much. Please make sure you look at the homework and have a nice day. Bye-bye.